Hi everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn how to add a recipient on your, or we can call them beneficiaries on your Nedbank online banking, right? So I've logged in. You have to log in to Nedbank secure.nedbank.co.za. Once you log in, it's gonna ask you username and password. I didn't pass through that because of security. And then you click. After doing that, then what's gonna happen is you're gonna be on the interface, which won't look like this. When you're there, you're gonna have to click on what they call recipients, right? Once we click on recipients, then we scroll here and say view recipients. Then you scroll up, then you say add a recipient, new recipient. So here, recipient name, we're gonna put a Masugu. Say Aubrey. Masugu. Okay, right. Then we add phone number or email address, whatever you want. I would like to say phone number. It's gonna be 06 something. I'm gonna pause, then I add on the phone number. Okay, then what you do, you add a bank account. I'm gonna force and put on the bank account. Bank, you put in the bank. Maybe this I'm gonna put in Time Bank. Okay, he's using Time Bank. We get that. Put in the bank account, put in your reference, and put in their reference. Your reference means what you're gonna remember. Their reference, you can say, okay, you can say that. Then after, add account, okay, add cell phone number, whatever. If you do that after, then you're gonna save that. So let's go. I'm gonna pause for now, then I come back after filling in those. So fill in those, then we're gonna go to the second step. Yes guys, once everything's done, it's gonna enable this button. You saw this button was not enabled, it was disabled. So once everything's done, it's gonna give you that button. Then it says save recipient. It's gonna give you those seconds, whatever has been sent to you. Then it say sent to you. So they're gonna send you something on the phone. Number one is gonna say accept. Number 9, press 1 to accept or 9 to reject. I'm gonna say 1 on my phone. Once I press, you're gonna see it's gonna go through. So once it's done, that was done. Okay, so since this is done, it's super cool. That's the way you do that, you get me? So you can log out now, and once you've logged out, so here we done putting that recipient. That guy is gonna be a beneficiary. And then what happens now, here is how you log in. This is something which I passed. You put in whatever, remember the old Nedbank account, what internet bank, it could take your profile number, your PIN, your also your password. So three things, so it was a little bit difficult. I did one of the videos about how you to do what they call printout proof of payments and whatever on Nedbank app. So this is the process, is very simple. So I've added that guy, and also to pay, you will see how to pay a beneficiary there. It's simple, pretty simple. Since this guy is in, I made a video showing you how to put a beneficiary in that. So there are a couple of things anyway you can do by just playing on the app. It won't chow your money. I just felt like it's necessary for us to show you things like that. So Nedbank app, the old one, was not that 100% perfect, but this one I believe it's going to be a bit better for people. Why? Because it's a bit user friendly than the previous one. Though I wouldn't say it's the best, but they've tried to make it a little bit easier. banks, they don't do things, they do things, same things, but in a different way. They could be the reason why maybe they were giving us three inputs last time, because of security. They wanted you to know your profile number, which is very difficult to cram into your head. So then they give you the pin is easy to have. Password is easy to understand, to remember. But the most difficult thing there was what they call the profile number. Myself, I didn't know my profile number. I was just relying on the browsers, you get me? So to save them, it could save some things, but not all things, you get me? So, which was a little bit difficult for me to work with. So every time when I think of doing money, what, online banking, I was thinking of that. So I was in most cases using the app, and on the app some things were not there on the app, you get me? Even on this one, on the app, some things you cannot get them right, you get me? So, but when you're using this, I believe it's better. So the tutorial today was just all about how to add a beneficiary, which is fine. And you guys, if you have any problem or anything you want me to cover on FNB, Nedbank, Standard Bank, what they call Capitec, all those three banks, four banks, let me say, Nedbank, Capitec, Standard Bank, FNB, four of them I can do videos about them. I don't do Absa, and I don't do Time Bank, and I don't do other banks. So, but the four major banks, I know also Absa is a major bank, but these are the biggest banks for me I cover. So I cover four banks for now. Maybe, I don't know, maybe next year we can add on another bank, but those are the banks we cover, guys. So if you have any question about those banks, you can ask me to do a tutorial about how to, like the one which I made, how to print out an invoice, what they call proof of payment. You can say how to print out a letter of confirmation letter, how to print out what they call a proof of residence on your bank account, online banking. How to, this time how to add a beneficiary. So once you add a beneficiary, it's easier to pay someone. So here, the same thing, I can, like what I've done, that beneficiary is gonna appear on my app. So I'm using a computer now, but now once I'm there, it's gonna be easier for me to use the app and see. So you know, the app sometimes, because the screen is a bit smaller, so it becomes a little bit challenging for people to do what, to use the app to do much of the stuff, most of the stuff. So what they do, so now to add beneficiaries, maybe you want to add 10 beneficiaries, easier on the computer than on the app, you get me? So if you add them there, you can go on the app and pay them, you get me? So you pay, also you can pay in bulk, something like that. So if you can't use your phone to pay, you can also still use the computer. But the reason why we use the computer much, because it has what, a bigger screen. So since it's a big screen, it's easier to see things, you get me? On the app sometimes you can claim I can't see this, but just because the app, it has those three lines on the left, on the right for Nedbank, so which makes it a little bit sometimes difficult for people who don't use phones a lot. So they wouldn't know that what this. Okay, so once you do that, after, I didn't tell you this, after approving the beneficiary, it's gonna send you an app. You're gonna find a message on your app saying you have approved the addition of a new beneficiary. Notice, you have approved the addition of adding, you have approved the addition of adding a new beneficiary to your profile, expire 2020 March 2021. You get me? So maybe they were saying you have approved adding Aubrey Masogo to your whatever, so personal whatever information have been compromised, in which case please, okay. Then they say here on the app, you're gonna find this information. Say you have approved addition, you have approved adding Aubrey Masugu to your saved recipient list. If this is known to you, your account and personal information may have been compromised, in which case please call 086-555-111 086. In case you find, like, maybe you want to report something, you can call 086-555, or we say 086-555-111 or 111. That's the thing. So they send you that message. They say, in case something happened, call them. If you see a beneficiary you never put on your account, right? So that's the thing, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please ask us for more, and also you can comment in the comment box below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.